Hello, all you lovely readers and writers out there. Welcome back to this quirky channel. Now, today we are going to change the topic yet again. Instead of focusing on literature, we're going to be focusing on TV series, and one in particular, Lucifer. Now, usually I don't have a great opinion about most of the recent TV shows, but you know what? I like Lucifer so much that today I'll just play the devil's advocate and I'm going to defend it because it deserves some credit. So, I'm not going to spoil the plot, I'm not going to go too deep in it, I'll just speak as usual about some general topics, share some of my opinions, and also say some very bad puns, as I usually tend to do. Now, Lucifer, how to describe the series? Well, it's basically CSI with attitude. It's CSI with a superhero, actually, because apparently Lucifer was based on a character created by Neil Gaiman. So, Lucifer belongs in the DC universe. He is the devil, and as such, he is this sort of an anti-hero, hero-ish sort of type. And he works. The character as it is designed, he just works. Now, why is it a CSI-themed, more or less, series? Well, you have the investigation part. He meets a detective, and they both solve crimes together. The series tends to go a bit, tends to use that trope, will they, won't they, a bit too much in my opinion. So it's a bit longer than I would have liked to. It's like 90 episodes long. I would have liked for it to be like, I don't know, 40. But even in those 90 episodes, it's just good. So Lucifer, he's called Lucifer Morningstar, right? The light bringer. So at a certain point, Lucifer decides to take a vacation from hell. And he goes to visit the city of angels, or the city of fallen angels. He goes to LA. So the Lightbringer in LA opens a nightclub, and he calls it Lux. All these little nuances give color to all the series, because it is just written perfectly. And you can see that they had material to work on because every single line they deliver just does not disappoint. You have so many jokes and so many different varieties of jokes because you have witty puns, you have puns that are inspired by either Bible events or Bible facts, and then you have corny jokes, dad jokes, and from time to time less than morally good jokes, let's call them. But again, the lines work. They are delivered perfectly also because the cast is very good, especially Tom Ellis. I adored his interpretation of Lucifer, and especially some of his accents and how he portrays the devil. They are just perfect. But there is something else that I adore about the character. You see, what the series does is just put a different characteristic to what you would expect. It's this trick, let's call it, that writers usually tend to do. So put a characteristic to a character that should not belong there. And in this case, Lucifer, the prince of lies, always tells the truth. And in my opinion, that is just perfect. And that works throughout the series because he usually talks about his problems. And his main problems would be he has a lot of daddy issues. And in this case, daddy is God. So he usually talks about his father and people just take it for granted. Oh yeah, he's talking about his normal human father. No, he's talking about God. But that's what the series does really, really well. There is character development. There is also a therapist that listens to the problems of not only Lucifer, there will also be other celestial beings. But keep that in mind, they have problems that are actually translated to human problems. So you have a cast of celestials or of, I don't know, superhuman or transcendental beings, entities, whatever, that are humanized to the point that they have real problems. And dealing with them, they grow. Finally, character development! And that's what I like. Also, a side note, the music in this series is fucking perfect. I mean, goddamn, every single song just fits to that particular scene. To be fair, I mean, give some sympathy to the devil because Beelzebub has a song put aside for every single stage. And I mean it. It's just that good. Also, if by my words you actually get hooked to this series, just wait till you get to the second part of the fifth season because that part is divine. And it is there that you see all the previous character growth actually reach sort of a climax and how things actually become. And in my opinion, all of these factors just combine to give you a series that it's worth watching. Now, again, I did mention this, but it is a little bit on the long side. I would have preferred it to be a bit shorter. But you know what? It's just good. It just works. I mean, if you think about it, you usually get hooked on a series more for the character. Who of us watched, I don't know, Dr. House because of the cases? We already know it's never lupus, and we already know that Dr. House will always solve the case. You watch it for Dr. House and for his caustic lines and whatnot. Same thing with Lucifer. You'd not watch it for all the CSI-based cases, for all the detective work. No, you watch it for the characters, you watch it for that dialogue, you watch it for how they interact with each other. And also, I did mention the fifth season. It is good for all the jokes. I laughed my ass off. But at a certain point, there were some emotional developments that I would have not have expected. And there was actually a tear in my eye at a certain point, which is why I believe it is a good series, because it actually made me feel something genuine for the characters. And that's, in my opinion, at least for me, that's something pretty rare. So if you like the video, I mean, give the devil his due. I would say give the devil his due and put a like, put a comment, whatever, and subscribe to the channel. But you know what? I don't care about that. Just give the devil his due and go watch Lucifer. It is worth it. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to breathe. Don't forget to smile. Those are usually important things. Have a nice one. Until next time.